Always in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad that these are blessed gatherings. If we khuluqul azeem, when we think that Prophet magnificent characteristic of when Allah, the Most High, Most Great, describes the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad that you are of a magnificent character from Allah means there can be no higher. And that with that beatific characteristic we are gathering in these associations. Do not think that Prophet is watching, that he's coming and making dua for everybody who's attending the association. It can escape his nazar. This association for 2 days is probably $8,000. It's not you guys driving from 5 minutes down your street. These gentlemen pay $500 tickets on their own and they fly in here, eight of these gentlemen here with the rentals, with every other expense, and they do it for the love of Sayyidina Muhammad because there's no way they're ever going to see it back. It's not something that you get back. But through the teaching is that we have to sacrifice for the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. We have to do something to get this love. Has to be real. It's not just you say, "I love somebody," but we didn't do anything for it. Blood, sweat and tears is in that love. So before, when they said they love, they gave their entire lives. So it means these are blessed associations. These gentlemen here have a tremendous amount of faith and love. No doubt that Sayyidina Muhammad is watching their every step and granting that faiz, granting that light, granting that blessing. And those whom open their house through sickness, through health, through every difficulty, keep the milad and the mawlid to keep moving. There's no doubt that the nazar of Prophet is under these associations. That is the beauty and the fragrance of this life. Without that, this life is for what? Eating, drinking and using the facility. There's no ruhaniyat and anything else. So means these are the barakah and the blessings of our lives. So no doubt when we're sitting in these few hours that we have together, that see ourselves at Rawza Sharif holding tight to the gate and said, "Ya Rasul Kareem, that you are the one whom Allah dressed from generosity. The most generous gift is just look at me. With your Divinely eyes gaze upon me, I'm set." If Prophet look, can anything ever come bad? No, you're under that intercession, under that nazar. They said that Mawlana Shaykh Abdul Faiz Dagestani said that for Mawlid the Nabi their angels are all belonging to Prophet, but for the milad and the celebration of the birth of Sayyidina Muhammad, there's an angel, these are the teachings of awliyaullah, angel that's so huge, grey and thunderous, and that angel is assigned to the milads. And anybody who makes an intention to make Mawlid the Nabi Allah assigns that angel onto that servant. That you are now responsible to be with that servant from the time they made their mawlid until the time they enter into their qabr. And in the qabr, that angel's responsibility is to convey the ni'mat and the blessing of that mawlid upon the servant. When Allah says He loves, khuluqul azeem, that you're my habib. All creation was looking for the love of Allah, but Allah was giving the love to Sayyidina Muhammad and trying to please Prophet. He's the Habib, everybody was looking for the love of Allah. Allah was describing Prophet, "He's my Habibullah, and I'm going to give everything to make you happy. I'm going to give all of that as a ni'mat and a gift." So then imagine the immensity of that mawlid, and every mawlid that we do, that angel's assigned. So that if a day of difficulty comes, a day of heedlessness comes, whatever is coming, I have in my account, "Ya Rabbi, your words are true, the way of Prophet is true," that that angel is responsible for me. So it means we can't imagine the immensity of blessings. Imagine doing that weekly, monthly, three times a week, yearly, whatever it is that we are doing and gathering for the love of Allah, love of Sayyidina Muhammad. Its immensity is something that can't be understood. We pray that Allah grant us to be gifted by its blessings. Even we don't know it, Ya Rabbi, don't matter, grant it for us. That it give us blessings in this life and in the grave and in the hereafter to sit at the table of Sayyidina Muhammad Ahbab and Nabi, the lovers, inshaAllah. The La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, I think it's on page 10 verse.
La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah alayhi salawatullah. La ilaha illallah.
Welcome to Muhammadan Way YouTube channel, your premier destination for videos on Sufi spirituality, classical Islamic teachings, and realities of the soul. With a library of over 1,000 videos and new titles uploaded weekly, join us to discover true meaning and inner peace in our often troubled world. Click the link now to subscribe.